It's the PFF Forecast team here. I'm George Chahrouri, joined by the big guy, Eric Eager. We're going to talk about the top 10 most valuable players, quarterbacks, offensive players that aren't quarterbacks, and of course, defensive players. Before we do, I want to remind you to get yourself a PFF Elite subscription. Not only will you get Premium Stats version 2, but you'll also get PFF Greenline, which is going to be our big product coming out very, very soon. All of the pick investment advice that you can possibly need will be there. So let's start with quarterbacks, as we do. The top five guys in terms of WAR, so wins above replacement, the guys that provided the most value above random quarterback that you pull off the street. No surprise here, Tom Brady leads the pack. Looking at the top five, what sticks out to you?
Yeah, I mean, for me, Alex Smith being in the top five, you know, we know that he led the NFL in passer rating, but in terms of our grades, he was not nearly as successful as some of these other quarterbacks. However, the Chiefs were successful, and then I think what's also true about Brady is true about Smith. The Chiefs last season in our defensive ratings had the worst PFF Massey defense, so there's just more wins on the table for the Chiefs to generate offensively, Smith being the most important player for them offensively, getting a lot of those wins above replacement as a result.
Yeah, you could easily see Alex Smith, I think, dropping off this, and we'll look at a couple of guys who might make the jump. So moving on to 6 through 10, starting with Phillip Rivers, Carson Wentz, Russell Wilson, Case Keenum, and Matt Stafford. The one here that sticks out to me, I think, is clearly Case Keenum. The guy had an upper-tier season in terms of what we've seen from him, avoided sacks at an amazing rate, was second in the league in terms of avoiding sacks under pressure, and had the supporting cast that I think you probably don't expect to see very often, if ever again. And so he's a guy that I might expect to fall off. And I think there's a couple guys there in Wilson and Wentz that you could see easily make that jump to the top five. If you had to pick one, who would it be?
I think for us, it's Russell Wilson, right? We see he has a track record of being extremely good. Seattle, a season ago, right, struggled. If they have a better season, there's going to be more wins above replacement for him to have. Also, offensively, they lose Paul Richardson. Their running game isn't quite that great yet. So in terms of if Seattle's offense is successful, it's going to be mostly Wilson's doing there. So he'll get a lot of those shares.
Yeah, what's interesting about Russell Wilson is how good he's been from a clean pocket. But he's under pressure so often that we almost sort of write that off. And so if I think of something that's consistent amongst quarterbacks, it's their performance from a clean pocket. Russell Wilson is so good from a clean pocket. There's one guy that's going to make that jump to the top five. I think it's going to be Russell Wilson. Let's move on to the non-quarterbacks. Looking at the top five guys here, anything you notice?
Well, it's everybody that catches the ball, right? So we have Thomas, Brown, Jones, Hopkins. Hopkins elevating an offense a season ago when he had Deshaun Watson. He led the NFL in receiving yards on wide receiver screens. Keenan Allen was an extremely valuable player last season for the Chargers, and then we have a lone tight end there in Rob Gronkowski. Again, much like Brady, there's a lot of wins to be attributed to the Patriots offense, despite the fact that really only two of them are superstars. That's why they get most of those win shares there. And then the running backs that are on the list are running backs that what, George?
Run the ball with power.
Power.
Power. And actually, they catch the ball.
They catch the ball, yeah. Because catching the ball matters.
Yeah, Alvin Kamara, generational talent, picked in the third round. Todd Gurley, of course, gets that all of a sudden amazing offensive scheme in there and is able to utilize his athletic ability in a way that generates value now instead of running into the backs of defenders. So that's awesome. I think one thing that's notable here is if I look at the top five, DeAndre Hopkins is the only guy in there who didn't have a really great quarterback throwing him the ball. What was interesting is with Watson on the field, his percentage of throws where he had at least a step or more of separation increased by 10%. Mm-hmm. You can do a lot of damage when you have a little bit of separation and are not always sort of trying to catch the ball in tight coverage. So a guy like DeAndre Hopkins really impresses me being this high on the list, without a quarterback that was great, at least for most of the season. So I think that's an interesting thing to note. And of course, Golden Tate. A lot of respect for Golden Tate. Let's move on to the top 10 defensive players, wins above replacement here. Not quite in general as valuable as the guys that are catching the ball, but there's still something pretty noticeable that we see stick out.
Right, and until you get to Damon Harrison at 10, almost all these players make the majority of their headway defensively by stopping the pass, right? So Bobby Wagner is a very good coverage linebacker, very like you know, one of the best we've seen. Luke Kuechly, similarly, I believe he won one of our coverage Players of the Year award at PFF. So even linebackers in this situation are guys that make plays defending the pass, and then the players who are up front are ones that rush the passer, and then the first player on the list is a guy who was, I think, without peer to some degree last season in terms of covering players in coverage.
Yeah, my boy Jalen Ramsey, the guy that I personally would take if I had to take any non-quarterback in a draft right now. Jalen Ramsey, I think, is the guy that
I'll
take.
Also, quarterback evaluator, too. It seems like those are, you know, the supply and demand there. I think Ramsey is angling in for a career after football.
Look, two birds, one stone, all about it. If there is one guy from these non-quarterback lists that you would pick to be the most valuable non-quarterback next year, who is it?
I think Ramsey is a good choice. I mean, the only issue there is that we know the Jaguars defense is already one of the best, if not the best, in the league. We see some regression possibly there. Another guy, Harrison Smith, is somebody who does kind of everything for Minnesota. He covers, he blitzes, he stops the run. He's horrific on one of the league's best defenses. So I think one of those two defensive backs, I think, are going to be the league's most valuable defensive player this season.
There you go. No Michael Thomas left. I'll take Michael Thomas repeating. My boy. That is the top 10, three different lists, quarterbacks, non-quarterbacks on offense, and defensive players. If you want more, definitely subscribe to the PFF YouTube channel. Check us out at the PFF Forecast. And of course, get yourself a PFF Edge and Elite subscription.